In this video, I'll show you how you can document and comment your code so you can get this nice looking Apple documentation that you see here, where you can have code samples, call out important bits, and you get little descriptions in your code completion, and this inline documentation to make your code base a joy to work in and welcoming to new developers on the team, and to be honest, you in 6 months when you forget why the hell you even wrote this code. You will be that new developer and you'll be happy that you had this documentation to help guide you. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. The documentation I'm about to show you is powered by what's called DocSee, and that was introduced in 2021. You can create references, articles, tutorials for your code base, and it's really aimed at those making third-party libraries where other developers need to really learn how to use your code, your library. So that's where the articles and the tutorials and all the code samples come into play. But in 2022, they made it available for your app in general using references so you can get this Apple-like documentation that I showed you in the intro. So in this video, I'm going to show you some examples of adding documentation to an existing code base, and I'm going to use the code base that we built in my latest course on the Portfolio Project, where we learn about HealthKit, charts, SwiftUI, source control. So if you're interested in that, check that out, seanallen.teachable.com. But I wanted to focus on the documentation and the comments, so we're using an existing code base. But before we dive into that, I want to talk about comments in general real quick, because I view this comment and documentation as just like the classic midwit meme. When you're a beginner, you use comments everywhere, and then as you get mid-level, right, just smart enough to be dangerous, you know, my code is self-documenting. It just write readable code. You don't need comments. My code is beautiful. And then the more senior you get, you're like, comment the hell out of your code. Give me great documentation. Give me that all day. And I don't say that to offend those that might be in that midwit area, because I'm almost 10 years into my career and I am just now coming out of that. Like, I spent a good 8 years in the midwit realm, so I understand what you're saying. All right, here I am in the HealthKit manager. What the code actually does, don't worry about. We're basically fetching step counts from HealthKit. You know, we're gonna focus on the documentation and how you get into DocSee world, right? You're probably used to just the double slash, here is a comment, right? You know that. Well, a triple slash gets you into DocSee land. You'll notice like the font is different. The font is different. So you can do triple slash to type it out manually, but there's a very helpful keyboard shortcut that is the only way to do it, in my opinion. Put your cursor into fetch step count, command option slash, and now it pulls from your function signature. It says, oh, this returns something. So let me put this returns in here. If you had parameters, it would list out all the parameters for you. But while we build this out, I also want to show you how you can preview your documentation as you're building it out. So over here where you're opening up your canvas, we'll do the assistant editor. And then now this dropdown right here starts off on counterparts, but all the way at the bottom, documentation preview. And then here is our very bare bones documentation for DocSee. And this is that familiar Apple documentation you may be used to. So this description is the quick little sentence describing what this function does. So that is fetch last 28 days of step counts from HealthKit. So that's our simple description of what the function does. This is also what's going to show up as you see here in the autocomplete preview. But we can build this out even more. So let's do what it returns. Right now, there's nothing in there. Say returns an array of health metric. Health metric is a type we have. You can see it right here. It returns an array of health metric. Because this is a type we have, we can do the double tick around it, and that will make it a link. Now you see it's a link. Now in our preview, we can't link to it. When we build our documentation, you can see how we can jump around. So you can link to other types in your code base, again, to get that Apple-like documentation. So this is the absolute bare bones, right? You got your description and what it returns, and if it had parameters, you could describe your parameters as well. We'll do that one in a little bit. But over here in our code, if you return twice, now you're in discussion land. So this is where if you want to have any discussion about what's going on in this function, for example, we'll say we take these HK statistics, which is what you get back from HealthKit, and then we convert it into an array of health metrics. So we'll just describe that real quick. But again, this description area, as you'll see, shows up as a discussion to just describe the function more. Converts an array of HK statistics of HK quantity type dot step count. And I'm pulling this right from here so you can see that. And because that is code, essentially, if you do a single tick, not a double back tick, single tick will give it that code type font as you see here over in my preview. And convert it into an array of, and we'll do double tick, health metric. And the double tick again gives us that link as you see there. So now you can see this documentation start to come together, right? We got our description, what it returns, returns an array of health metrics, any discussion you want to explain the function further. And we can even add code samples if we want to. So down here below the discussion, I will go a triple tick, and then you give the language and hit return. And the code we want here is, this is where we're converting this here, this step counts.statistics.map, you know, initialize the health metric and convert all that. So let's just say I wanted to show this code snippet of how we're converting the HK statistics into a health metric. So I'm gonna copy that, bring it up here into my code. And by the way, I hope this goes without saying, well, let me do a return triple tick. I need three slashes in front of that. And then we're gonna line this up. I'm missing my slashes here. There we go. And you don't want to use tabs because the documentation uses the tab. So space it over as you see fit. But essentially, yeah, triple tick, Swift, and then your little code snippet. And you can see it show up here now in our documentation if you wanted to give a code example to really illustrate like what you're explaining in the code. But you can start to see how we're building out our own documentation. It's very Apple-like where you can navigate around clicking to different types. You get a discussion on what the type is. You can have code samples. Now, old midwit Sean would have been looking at my code. I'm gonna minimize my documentation preview here. Like, what? I just added all this to my code. Now my code base is so cluttered. It's so messy, hard to read. Like that's what midwit Sean would have been saying. I would have hated this 2 years ago. Now, as I get, you know, more experienced, I'm like, oh yeah, give me all the documentation you got. This is so helpful. Like, aesthetics be damned. I want the code base to be useful and a joy to work in. Let's do one more real quick so I can show you how to use it with parameters and then also, you know, show off this important tag or warning or tip. So we'll scroll down a bit to our add weight data. And essentially this is us adding a new piece of weight data to HealthKit from our app. So click into add weight data, command option slash, and then now you see our preview updated with a new preview for add weight data. But you see, I got parameters now. It doesn't return anything, but I have parameters that I can describe. So for the description, I'll say write a new weight value to HealthKit. And the parameters are a date and a value, because when you send up a piece of data to HealthKit, you need to know, hey, what date was this weight logged in? And what is the value of the weight? Date for weight value. And for the value, I'll say weight in pounds as a double. And we'll put the double in the single ticks so we get that little code font. I want to say that, hey, writing this value to HealthKit, this requires HealthKit permissions, but I don't want that to be lost in the text. I want that to really stand out. So down here, I can do a greater than sign, and there's a couple different ones you can put. So I'm gonna put important with a colon, and you see that gives me the yellow important, and I'll say requires users HealthKit authorization, or however you want to word that. But see, important gives you yellow. Let's say warning. Okay, that's red. I think this is pretty cool. Tip will give you the teal. There's also experiment. So you can really annotate your documentation, you know, with whatever you need to do. And I really like this one because, like I said, it really makes things stand out because let's be honest, we all just skim the documentation for what we need. And anytime I see one of these important or warnings, like my eyes go right to it. And then of course, if you wanted to describe the function a little bit more, you would write, you know, here is where the discussion would go to describe the function even more. So over here in our preview, you can see we get the little description, we can describe our parameters and what they do, add a little discussion on that, and give the, you know, important flag or warning flag, really making a piece of information stand out. Now let's build our documentation so we can see this in action. So product, build documentation, and it'll build it just like it normally does. But this will give us, again, that Apple-like documentation that we can navigate around in. And this will look pretty familiar to you. So here it is, the Step Tracker app, and it pulled in all of our classes, all of our structs, all the types that we have. But let's go to the HealthKit Manager, because that's the only one we've added documentation to. And if I look at my instance methods, look, we added descriptions to add weight data and fetch step count. So if we really built this out, everything we had here would have all this description. Let's go into add weight data. See, here's the basically what we saw in the preview with the parameters and the discussion. Let's go back to fetch step count. What does that do? Oh, and here's how we can navigate around. Ah, returns an array of health metric. What's a health metric? Click into health metric. Here's what it is. Here's the properties. And of course, you know, this will be built out with documentation as well. So hopefully you're starting to see how valuable and useful this is. Now, of course, there's no denying it's time consuming. Like, that's objectively true. But if you're building a very large app and have a large team, I think the productivity gains are well worth taking the time to have great documentation. And on top of what I just showed you, being able to navigate around and see these descriptions, you get the little description on the autocomplete, which is super helpful, like at the time of use. And then of course you get the inline documentation as you're using the code base up here that can be very helpful, again, also at the time of use. Now, if you're here learning how to document your code and make your code base better, I know you're building awesome apps and it's a great idea to have a portfolio website to showcase your work. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're developers, we can build a website ourselves, but we're also iOS developers, and I would argue there's an opportunity cost of your time. Now, do you want to spend your time learning about web development, responsive design, all the different browsers, or do you want to spend your time building apps? So that's why I always recommend letting Squarespace take that off your plate to build your iOS developer portfolio. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started, and you can use their next generation website editor with the Fluid Engine to just really unlock all the creativity in the world. You can even use Squarespace Blueprint and Squarespace AI to help you figure out what to write on your website, because that's always the hardest part. Like, I don't even know what to say here. Throw it into Squarespace's AI and they'll help you out. They handle all the SEO and analytics for you. Again, Squarespace handling your website just takes so much off your plate. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.